Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, now we are going to talk about sublimation. In the previous lecture, we have studied about that there are different kinds of methods used to purify an organic compound, in which one was that is the sublimation process. And what is actually sublimation? Let us talk about that. So talking about the definition of the sublimation is nothing but the process by which a solid substance on heating change directly to the vapor state without passing through the liquid state is known as sublimation. So this is a kind of process that we are going to talk about, that is sublimation, in which a basically solid substance is being converted into a gaseous substance or it's a vaporized phase, in which we could see that the liquid phase is being formed. So this kind of process is basically known as sublimation, and that we know well. And for example, if we could say that is there are certain organic compounds that are solid, but they don't convert into liquid while heating, but eventually they convert into its vapor phase. And what are those compounds? They are commonly that we know it as naphthalene, camphor, ammonium chloride, that is NH4Cl, iodine. So these are such compounds, or these are such solid compounds, that on heating it convert into vaporized phase. So how can we recover that compound that has been vaporized? So that is what I wanted to show you. That is, whenever a solid is been converted into a, suppose, gaseous phase, or if I would say vaporized phase, so that would involve the involvement of heat. And suppose if that vapor phase is now been converted into a solid phase by cooling, so we could get the solid phase. So in that case, suppose what we do is we basically for us to separation, the sublimation method is been used. So let me give you an example. This is the total setup of the sublimation process. So how it is been done, let me tell you. So suppose if I've taken a mixture of that is ammonium chloride and NaCl. And this is the burner that we have, and we have kept those mixture, that is a mixture of NaCl and ammonium chloride, that is NH4Cl, and we have kept in a china dish, and we have covered it with a inverted funnel. And even here, as you could see, a caudal plug has been covered so that the gas should not get vaporized, or it should not escape from this thing. And we could see that if we burn it, so because of the NaCl that has been present, as well as the ammonium chloride that has been present, and among that, ammonium chloride, that is NH4Cl, has a capacity to sublime, means it is the one that won't form a liquid phase, and it will directly convert into a solid phase, it will directly convert into a vapor phase. So whenever we heat it, so what will happen is it will try to convert into vapor phase. But since the cotton plug has been used and there is no chance to get escape, so in that case what happens is even the process of cooling will take place over in that case, because the heat area is up till this much, but here it is a bit cool region, and that's the reason that the solid appears here. And that is the reason we could easily separate and easily can purify a particular ammonium chloride. So suppose if we are talking about the separation, then we could easily separate by using the sublimation process. And when we are talking about the that is purification, suppose in that case, suppose only we have to take the ammonium chloride and we have to evaporate, and that's the reason that we could see that all the product that has been formed over here, they will be fine crystals of the ammonium chloride, or they would be a fine solid, and that would be a purified product of the ammonium chloride that we could get. So this is a kind of sublimation process that I wanted to explain you. So it's a very easy process, but this is only possible for those substance or those solids only which has the capacity to sublime. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly, and you have got an experimental setup also, so as to understand practically. And so thank you for watching this video, and share this video with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.